Hi, Alex here from redeveloper.com. Now in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make your app extremely beautiful with animations. If you want to know tips and tricks of the secrets of the animation, transitions and blur, then keep on watching. Are you ready? Hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode and let's make an app that looks awesome with animations. So let's take a look at our example because in an image you can't really see an animation. So this is our demo. So what we are going to build out today is this spring effect. So we are scaling this text. Then we are going to tap on this icon and have this awesome animation with the background icons. And then just to top everything off, we are going to do this animation. And as a surprise bonus, let me just drag this around. How awesome is that? And when I let it go, it just goes back into there. And just notice that the background cards have a blur effect. Awesome. So let's just jump right into the code. So we have created here for you a starter project. And go ahead and take a look at the GitHub repository down in the link below in the description so you can just follow along. And let's just stop the other one from building and running and let's just focus on this new one. Of course, you can have access to all of these resources in the links down below, like these images and all of these files. Okay, so let's just move on real quick and I will just guide you through what we have just built right here, right off the top. So we have a title view, an icons view and a cards view, and it is vertically stacked. Here we have our title view. We are going to start our coding here, and we have our icons view where we just basically Z stack free icon views. And these icon views are just a basic images that have a lot of modifiers, of course. And finally, we have our cards view, just the same free card views here. And here is our cards view just to take a look at it. Okay, that is basically it. So let's just jump right into today's animation coding. So here we have our text, and this is of course, at the moment, static. So what we want to do is when we tap on it, we want to make a scale effect on it. So let's just add a modifier here. So dot on tap a gesture, and we will add our code here. For now, let's just print out, let's say here, tapped. Okay, so let's build and run and see how that looks. Of course, in this simple example, I will guide you through line by line, but in the next three ones, I'm just going to skip over what you have already learned. So there we go, it says tapped, awesome. Okay, now we want to add this scale effect on our text. So let's do that right here. Just type in this scale effect with a scale of S. Okay, there we go. And let's see, let's have our scale effect to 1.2. Of course, this will not take any effect on our tap gesture because we just simply added this scale effect to 1.2. And yeah, again, if we tap, nothing really happens. But if you really noticed, this is a little bit bigger, this text. So what we need to do, and I have already laid this out for you, we want to have a show title state variable, and we are going to set this to false because yeah, it is set to false by default. And when we tap on this text, we are going to toggle it and set it to true or of course false if the initial value is true. So let's do that first. And then we are going to use that on our text. So self.showTitle, just simple toggle. And I'm using toggle here because yeah, we don't know if the current state of showTitle is true or false. And I'm just going to delete this because we don't need that anymore. Now that we have this and the state variable does change its values over time when we tap on our text, we are going to use its value to set the scale effect. Okay, so it's pretty simple. We just want to have typed here show title, and we are going to use a ternary operator. What that means is just we are going to add a question mark here, and if it is true, we are going to set it to 1.2, and if it is false, we are just going to set it to 1, the effective scale of our title. So let's build and run again and see how that looks, because it will look awesome. Of course, it's not just a simple animation, but it will scale. It will be choppy, but yeah, there we go. It's scaling back and forth. Awesome. Now, all we have to do is just add some ease in and out animation to this. And that is, again, pretty simple with Swift UI. Let me just add a dot here to add our modifier. And all we have to do is animation. And we are just going to choose this first one. And dot ease in out. I'm just going to choose that one. Okay, hit Command R to build and run this project again. And we are done with our basic simple animation. But of course, it is not just that simple. Think of it how you would do this in UIKit. It's a pain. Okay, there we go. How awesome is that? The time for this basic animation is in, is out. If you don't have any duration to it, it's just 1 second. So there we go. How awesome is that? Okay, that is for our title view animation. Now let's just jump right into the icons view. And let me just iterate here what you already know and what is already in the default project. So if you go into the icon view, you see that I have already added this animation ease in out with our duration. And the duration is the animation duration declared here as a double, because yeah, the basic one is 1 second, but I want to have those two icons in the background to animate at different durations. So that is how I'm just moving the animation duration inside the icon view from the icons view. There we go. Here we have our animation duration. And of course, we have our image name. You already know that by now. Okay, so first, what do we want to do? Well, first of all, let's take care of our scale effect, because you already know that. So here, I'm just tapping on this third icon that I have added here, and I'm toggling the icon tabbed state right here when I tap on basically on the middle icon. So what we are going to use is this icon tabbed, and I'm just going to add this in here. Let me just remove this space. So if this is true, I'm just going to set it to 0.7. And if it is false, then 0.8. As you can see, I have added a cheat sheet here for myself, because there are a lot of values here. That is not the point of this tutorial. So let's just move on. And again, icon tabbed for the scale effect. There we go, 0.7 and 0.8. And as you can see here, oh, I need this. Here we have 1.2, because I'm scaling the image, or the icon rather, in the middle to 1.2 and then back. And I'm of course scaling the other twos, but not in that sense of scale. Okay, let's just try to build and run this and see what actually happens. Of course, this is on an icon tabbed gesture. Okay, let's just tap on this third icon. This is icon 3. Awesome. All of them for the background. The background ones are scaling down, and the one in the middle is scaling up. Awesome. Okay, now let's add this awesome rotation 3D effect, and it goes just like the same. So we are going to use the icon tab, and here we have 15 and 0. Okay, here we have our axis rotation. You can take a look at the details in the proper modifier. Again, 15 and 0. And that is it. Let's just build and run again and see how that looks like. And now we should see them just tilting some sort of back. There we go. Awesome. Well, we can't really see them, so I want to move them to the side of our screen, and that is with an offset. So let's add our offset here, 280. So again, these are for the states of icon tab 2 and 4. There we go. Let's do this one, minus 200 and minus 80. Awesome. And let's, just for a little Y offset, let's add in here minus 10 and 0. Please notice that on the background icons, I have set X offset, and on the icon in the middle, I have set Y offset. You can do both X and Y if you wanted to. So let's build and run again and see this kind of awesome combination of animations. Okay, let's just tap on this. How cool is that? And please notice that this icon on the left is going to reach its animation much faster than this one on the right. So again, let me just tap on it. Awesome. Cool. That is that. So real quickly, let's just jump into the third and final animation that is so cool, and that is in the cars view. Again, it's kind of the same, so we are adding a scale effect, an offset, and you will learn how to add blur, and finally we are going to add a drag gesture. There are a lot of modifiers here, and let's just jump right into our show cards. Let me just copy this out. I'm just going to do this real quick. You already saw this in the icons view. So 0.9, and let's just add this here. A question mark, 0.9 again. And basically that is it. Let's do the same for the offset. Okay, let me just add here. And the offset, we have X and Y values here. And first of all, let's have 14 and 0. You can tweak this if you wanted to. Just make sure that you understand that show cards is a state variable that we are going to use. Minus 200 here and minus 40. Okay, and let's do the same for our second card view here. So let me just pay attention here. And there we go, question mark, 220 and 40. Okay, we are done with this. So let's take a look at how this looks upon our tab gesture. As you can see here, we have our toggle on the car, a third car view toggle. Okay, let's just tap on it. It looks right, decent, but we still have to do some other stuff. Okay, what we want to do here is just add a blur radius. Now, just think of the blur radius. We want to have that on the initial state and not when the show cards is set to true. So we want to have this as 0 and 3. Okay, again, here 0 and 3. Okay, let's build and run again and see how that looks like. Real nice, real nice. Okay, now let me just, as you can see here, we have our blur, okay? And once we have that, we are moving away from that blur. Alrighty then, I believe we need to have minus 40 here. So I already saw there's a some sort of discrepancy here on the animation. Let me just fix that and double check if we have this right. Yeah, looks much, much better, as it should be. Okay, now we want to add our drag gesture. So that is pretty simple. On the third card, we want to add our gesture. So let's just add our gesture here. So here we want to add a drag gesture, and I'm just going to copy this out from and paste it out from my clipboard. And basically what we have here, let me just hit select all of this and hit Control I so we get the indentation correctly. So here we have our drag gesture, and on changed and on ended. Now on changed is when you actually drag your view, and the view is of course the card view. We are going to change these values, okay? The show card will be true, so it will basically expand. And when we end this, it will collapse. And we are also changing this view state. So let me just talk what this view state is. First of all, if it is ended, we are going to go back to the original CG size zero of our card view, basically back to zero. And while we are dragging, we are going to use this value that we get from onChange, and we are going to use its translation. Translation is basically where it is in our coordinating system. And we are going to add that to our view state. Now, as you can see, it already highlighted this up, and we already have these two. We are basically adding this view state into our card view. And let's just go to our card view, how we are going to use that. We are going to offset this basically view according to the view state width and the view state height. So we are just moving to the specific place where we are dragging it. And while we are at it, let me just add this rotation effect, because build and run and see why we do need this rotation effect anyway. So let's just build and run here, and we should see a drag effect. So first of all, let's just tap. That works fine. Okay, and just notice the awesome blur animation. And now when we drag, it's just dragging it along. Awesome. It looks real nice. And when I just let go, it goes back into its initial state. But if you just take a look at this drag, it doesn't really look nice. It's just like a stair or something. I want to tilt it. So that is why we have here a rotation effect of an angle, and we are going to use 10. Of course, we need to know when we are going to tilt this. So we are using this show card binding. Go ahead and take if you do want to learn more about bindings and state, go ahead and comment down below in the comment section, hashtag I like it. So I know that you want to know more about binding and states. Okay, let's just add this show card here, question mark. And let's get this trinary on the road. Now we will have a 10 degrees tilt when we drag this card. Awesome, looks much, much better. Great. So that is it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed this awesome animation tutorial series. Now, at this point in the video, I've pretty much spelled a lot of beans of how you can use animations, transitions, and of course, blur. However, if you are struggling a lot with dynamic lists, then I want you to hit that notification bell, because in the next video, we are going to talk about dynamic lists, HStack, WeStack, ZStack, and images. So make sure you hit that notification bell so you don't miss that video. In the meantime, while you wait for that video, make sure to also check out these two videos that I have over here. I talk a lot about development in iOS, Swift UI, and a lot more on how to code smarter. And as always, I will see you in the next one.